In this video, I'll be wiring up the machine itself and finalizing my MPCNC build. As always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. In this video, I'll be wiring the machine itself. For wiring the stepper motors, I've chosen this Cat5 Ethernet extension cable. I find that the extension cables actually have a stranded core wire on the inside as opposed to single core wire, which apparently isn't as good for moving back and forth. Once again, for connecting the stepper motors on all axes, I'm going to be using these aviation type connectors. I've found that the female end without the screw fitting fits through the 1-inch pipe and the male end doesn't. So I'm going to be putting the male end on the stepper motors. The way I chose to wire the plug to the stepper motor was to pre-shrink a piece of heat tube. That way I could slide it even further down inside of the stepper motor. I then went and slid the PETG braiding down inside the heat shrink and then heat shrink down with a heat gun. After which I then pulled the braiding back down to expose the wires. And I just pinched this down with my soldering stand. Afterwards I then went and connected my male aviation plug and soldered the corresponding wires against each other. Before soldering on the male aviation plug, I've also slid on a piece of heat shrink over the plug and the braiding once I pull it back up. Off camera, while I was flashing the board, I also pre-made these series stepper motor wiring pre-wired harnesses, which originally what I was going to do was to run two wires for each stepper motor out from the junction box, but I've realized this is really a waste of cabling, so I'm going to be putting these series stepper motor splitters at the end of the axes where I'll run a cable chain from. So far these Ethernet cables, I've had an eight core inner to them. So I've decided for each stepper motor to gang up two wires each going to each motor. After wiring in the splitter to the female end of the aviation connector, here I am joining the other end to the Ethernet cable that's going to be running down the 1-inch pipe to the stepper motor on the other end. I've done this with basically the same process of covering it with braiding and heat shrinking the ends off. After connecting both ends of motor 1 on the y-axis, I'm now starting motor 2 on the other side. I'm going to be doing this motor with basically the same steps as before by using a female aviation connector, some PETG braiding, and soldering the connections. I've also chosen to, on this end, to label the connection with Y motor 2. I'm going to do that by just printing out a label on a piece of paper that I'll then clear heat shrink over the top, and I'll use two pieces of black heat shrink to heat shrink the ends as well. So this is where I'm at. I've wired both the axes in the exact same configuration as I showed. I've also made a harness for the Z motor, the laser and the fans, which unfortunately I've lost a bit of footage for. So now, next, I'll be running the cable chains and cable management. For For running the cables, I've 3D printed these standoffs to zip tie on top of the stepper motor, which I've just quickly sketched these as I don't know how I'm going to run it yet. I was going to use these tape measure bands covered in PETG braiding to run the cables, but unfortunately I couldn't get it to support the cables, which is a shame because I really wanted to do it that way. So instead I bought these 20 by 30 cable chains off eBay, and I bought them instead of 3D printed them because I like the way the bought ones run. They only flex a certain way and they typically tend to run real smooth, so I should quite easily be able to get these to suspend above the machine with little or no extra support. First up, I'm installing my cable chain staunchion. I've just designed this to zip tie to the top of the stepper motor on each axis. Off camera, I've also two-part epoxied this 20 by 20 piece of aluminium to the center assembly, to the XYZ piece on the center assembly. I've gone a little bit further past where the end of the cable chain attaches, because I find this helps support the cable chain. To install the cable chain to the piece of 20 by 20 aluminium, I've just used two 20mm roofing tech screws. As for now, I'm just going to rough in my cable management system till I'm sure I've got it all set and dialed in the way I want it. On the Y-axis staunchion, I've decided to also add in another piece of aluminium underneath just to help support the cable chain along its length. And I am pretty happy with how this has turned out. It is exactly what I wanted. Here I am installing the staunchion I've made for the X axis. It just zip ties in exactly the same way as I've designed on the Y axis. And yet again, I've just chosen to screw in these cable chains with two 20mm roofing screws. Off camera, I've roughed in a staunchion for the back corner of the machine, which I've just extended out the two pieces of all thread and used to bolt down the corner pieces together. I'm just roughing this in again until I'm absolutely certain I've got my cable arrangement how I want it. Once I bolted in this corner staunchion, I then went and tech screwed in the rest of my cable chains as I've done on the rest of the build. With all three of the cable chains installed and a rough idea of where I want them to run to, I then went and ran through the last of my cables where they'll run out to the back corner, and then I'll start testing each axis at the control box. And here's a quick overview of the machine and its current configuration, which is really the beauty of this mostly printed CNC, is you get to make it your machine. Here I am wiring my first aviation connector for the Y axis going into the junction box. This will allow me to test my Y axis, and then I'll wire the rest of the axes the same way, and hopefully I should be up and running. So I've finished wiring the rest of my aviation connectors. All done the same way. Just one for each axis and my laser and fans. And then here I'm just demonstrating a quick test of the machine moving along both axes. I still don't have my lead screw yet, so I'll be doing that last. Next, seeing as it's really the only thing I can do, is I'll be doing a test with my laser. I did find that my laser didn't really perform any differently with the length of cable, so I am going to mount the laser controller in the junction box the way I originally had planned. So I've finally gotten my lead screw and now I'm going to be installing it on the center assembly. So after removing the Z-axis assembly, I'm now going to begin installing the center nut. You may also notice that the center bolts for the bearings in the center of the center assembly, I've actually had to grind those down as well so the tool mount will fit past. Also notice too that this lead screw nut doesn't fit with this Allen key socket cup bolt, so I'm going to grind out a little bit off the back of this lead screw nut. With the lead screw nut ground out and it fitting nice and snug, I then went and installed the lead screw into the Z-axis assembly. I've also decided that I want to pack the center assembly filled with some grease. I didn't get too technical. I just stuffed a bit of masking tape down the hole and then fill the joint with some grease before assembling the center assembly. For the lead screw T8 nut, I don't think it actually says in the V1 instructions what bolts you're meant to use. So for now, I've just threaded in some of these M3 10mm bolts. And now finally that I have my lead screw installed, I can try out pen plotting, which I've been waiting a while to give this custom design pen holder of mine a go. Thanks for watching. That's it for my MPCNC build log. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and keep an eye on this space because there'll always be more CNC videos coming.